In the treatment, the basic aim of our treatment is, you know, there is something which causes all the damage to the nose. So that has to be eliminated from the nose. And second, there are so many excessive crusting in the nose. So this crust has to be removed and the nasal mucosa has to be moisturized. And also the nasociliary function has to be replaced as far as possible. So the aim of treatment, whether it is medical or surgical, these are the aims. One is to eliminate the incriminating factor in the nose. Second, moisturize the nasal mucosa. Then clear the nasal crust. And four is to improve functionality. That is basically the nasociliary clearance of the nasal mucosa. So for this, the most important one is douching. We have to douche with a hypertonic and alkaline solution in the nose. So that what will happen? We can moisturize and also we can clear the nasal crust. When this has gone, this functionality will come back or it will improve. Okay. And for removing the, I already told you there are so many bacterias found to be in the found in the nose in a patient of atrophic rhinitis. So for that we can also give antibiotics like rifampicin. So the main medical treatment is regular cleaning or nasal douching with a hypertonic and alkaline solution. There are so many solutions available in the market. Solutions used for nasal cleaning. The first one is most commonly used because it is a hypertonic as well as alkaline solution. Hypertonic, alkaline, douche. Okay. So sodium bicarbonate, sodium diborate and sodium chloride in the ratio of 1:1:2 in 280 ml of warm water. Sodium chloride is two amount because to make it hypertonic. So these three 1:1:2 added in 280 ml of warm water give a very good result in this. After douching with this alkaline solution, you can paint the nose with 25% glucose in glycerin. Because this will inhibit the growth of proteolytic organisms in the nasal cavity. You can also give gentamicin in saline nasal douche or estradiol in oil can be painted in the nasal mucosa. Another thing usually asked in exam is chemisetin solution. It is a combination of estrogen, vitamin D and chloramphenicol given for nasal douche. And also mandel's nasal paint can be used, that is estradiol in potassium iodide. Mandel's nasal paint for local application. These are all local solutions for nasal cleaning or nasal paint. And the drugs given are usually tab rifampicin orally 600 mg per day for a period of 12 weeks. And recent evidence show giving norfloxacin for long term. The details are not available, but there are so many studies pointing towards norfloxacin, usually asked in MCQ. So rifampicin and norfloxacin are the two drugs which can be given in atrophic rhinitis. So these are the medical treatment. And if this patient is not getting adequate relief with this medicine, or showing a very low compliance with this conservative treatment, you have to go for surgery. So in surgery, what is the basic aim of surgery? You know the nose is very roomy, so that the airflow to the nose is more and it will cause drying effect, isn't it? So this drying effect has to be reduced, or airflow into the nose has to be reduced. For that we have to reduce the volume of the nose, that is the medial and the lateral wall has to be approximated. That is the basic aim of surgery, that is closure of the nose or approximation of the medial wall with the lateral wall. I already told you in the nose it is this become very roomy nose, so that this air will go there causing more of drying effect. So this has to be, these two has to be approximated. That is the basic aim of surgery. So what are the surgical options available? So we can divide the surgical options under various headings. One is to decrease trauma of air turbulence. I already told you, because of the roomy nose, the more air will go inside. So there are two methods to reduce that. One is nasal closure. That is, in the nose, you know, this is lateral wall and center is a nasal septum. And there is mucosal lining over that. Okay. So inside, so we have to reduce this or close the flow. So in Young's operation, what we do that, we make a elevator flap from both lateral wall and also from the medial wall, and we close it. So complete closure is Young's operation. And in modified Young, what we do that, we keep around four to five millimeter space in between. That is modified Young. So that complete closure is not done. If it is completely closed, it is Young's. And in modified Young's, there is a small passage is kept patent around 3 to 4 millimeter size. Passage is kept intact. So that's more advantages are. The advantages of modified Young are, through this we can put an 2.7 mm pediatric scope and we can see the progress. That is one thing, one advantage. Second, all the alkaline douche solutions I have already told you, and also 25% glucose and glycerin drops can be instilled through this, so that the pathology inside or the disease inside can be kept under control. And we cannot do on both sides, because if you do a Young's operation, imagine closing your both nostrils at a time, it causes so many difficulties. But in modified Young can be done on both sides in single sitting, and the patient will be comparatively more comfortable than a Young's operation. And in Young's operation, there will be changes in the voice changes, closed voice will be there. But in modified Young, if we are doing on both sides also, this voice change will not be that much apparent. So these are the advantages of modified Young. Okay, in Young's operation, we completely close the nostril. But in modified Young's operation, a 3 to 4 mm gap is kept there. Okay, up to 5 millimeter size you can keep. So this is Young and modified Young. And what you do in volume reduction? That is basically this medialization of the lateral nasal wall is volume reduction. So here there are turbinates, so we have to reduce the okay. So this medial lateral nasal wall is medialized in volume reduction. One is Lawton's Rama. What will you do in that? In that, we will fracture the lateral nasal wall and it is medialized. So, this is medialized. So, the volume is of the nose is reduced. And in Wilson, we inject submucosally, Teflon is injected into the lateral nasal wall so that it is approximated medially. So, submucosal injection of Teflon is Wilson. Lawton's Rama, we are fracturing the lateral nasal wall and keeping it medially. And another one is sublabial implants like bone, cartilage, sialastic, plastic pore. Implants are kept sublabially so that again the volume of the nose nasal cavity is reduced. And in vestibuloplasty, what we do is we put a flap from the vestibule and it is put over the lateral nasal wall, over the turbinates. Okay, so a vestibular flap is raised and it is kept over the turbinates on the lateral nasal wall. Vestibular flap is kept over the lateral nasal wall. So again the volume is reduced. So all these surgeries are for volume reduction. You have to study this, because the surgical treatment options for atrophic rhinitis is again a sure short note. Okay. Then another surgical procedure is aiming at increasing the nasal secretions. That is, one is by Wittmann's operation. That is, parotid duct is implanted into the maxillary antrum. Okay, that is Wittmann's operation, parotid duct implantation into the maxillary sinus. so that these nasal secretions are increased, right? From the maxillary antrum, it will go into the nasal cavity, called Wittmaack's operation. And also we have denervation surgeries, so that the vascularity of the nose is increased. We can go for a cervical sympathectomy or a stellate ganglion block or a spinopalatine ganglion block. So this you have to remember. These are the basic surgeries with the aims of each surgeries. And if the patient is not willing for surgery, you can also advise nasal obturators. Nasal obturators can be kept inside the nose so that the surgical morbidity can be avoided. It is easily removable also, but it is causes it's quite uncomfortable to the patient, and because of the patient goes for mouth breathing, it causes severe discomfort also. So these are the treatment options available for atrophic rhinitis. If any doubt, just ask in the comment box. Thank you.